Hello, everyone. Welcome again to another Word for Today with Ray. And before we begin, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for your Word. Thank you for the way that you daily teach us when we look into your Word about you and your Son, Jesus. We know you want us to know about your ways and the ways that you want us to be in this world. So we ask that you teach us by your Holy Spirit today those things which you'd have us to know and the ways that you'd have us to be. And we'll give you thanks for it in Jesus' name. Amen. The title to today's lesson is Children of the Free. And it's taken from Galatians chapter 4, verse 31. When we consider the words of Paul the Apostle to the church members in Galatia, we should keep in mind that they are being inspired by the Holy Spirit of God. And rather than only being the words of Paul, they are God Almighty's. God is concerned that people know the truth about being free from the bondage of keeping the law. And since he paid the ultimate price to set us free from the law, he desires that we know it. The Lord Jesus uses Paul's words in chapter 4 and verse 31 of Galatians to finalize his example of the free child of Abraham, Isaac, and to let all who read them know they are the children of the free. He wrote, "So then, brethren, we are not children of the bondwoman, but of the free." Paul began, "So then, brethren." In other words, Paul wrote in conclusion to this whole pattern or thought, or since this example is so, Paul has used the children of Abraham to demonstrate how one child, Ishmael, was the work of the flesh and Isaac was a work of the Spirit. Isaac was promised, and Ishmael was Abraham and Sarah's effort to fulfill that promise. Isaac was born of the Spirit as God restored to Abraham and Sarah the time of life so they would have a child in their old age. Ishmael was Abraham and Sarah's effort to produce what God could only do. Isaac was born of the free woman, and Ishmael was born of the bondwoman. Paul continues, "We are not children of the bondwoman, but of the free. Likened to Isaac, who was born of the free woman, we are not children of the bondwoman, but are born of the free. Our efforts to keep the law of God are much like the efforts of Abraham and Sarah to fulfill the promise of God. It is only a work of the flesh to do so. And it will never produce righteousness because we cannot keep the law of God perfectly. Only Jesus did that. And now because he made the sacrificial offering for our sins, we are set free. We are no longer bound to the failings of attempting to keep the law, but we are liberated unto his righteousness. Jesus paid the price, and we are the benefactors." Again, let us remember that Paul wrote words that were inspired by the Holy Spirit of God. And it is God who desires to let us know that because of what he did, we are free. We are free to have a relationship with him. We are free to have fellowship with him. And we are free from the bondage that was created by attempting to keep the law of God in order to be saved. May the word freedom reign in our hearts today as we ponder the wonderful love of our Savior Jesus and the sacrifice he made on our behalf that we might be in a relationship with him. Thank God we are children of the free. Next time, we will begin a new chapter and discover how we are to be since we are free. So read ahead and let us join together then. Until tomorrow, there is more. And may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you. May he be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace as you continue to study his word. In Jesus' name.